So here I take a look at the formation of the polyester known as terylene, made from a dicarboxylic acid and a diol. So there's our dicarboxylic acid. You can see it's got a benzene ring between two carboxyl groups. And here's our diol. You can see that we have OH groups at both ends. The dicarboxylic acid is called benzene-1,4-dicarboxylic acid, and the diol is known as ethane-1,2-diol. And this is how they interact. You can see that the OH of the carboxyl group of the dicarboxylic acid interacts with the H from the diol. You will notice there that the OH of the carboxyl group that comes away with the bond, the two electrons between the carbon and the oxygen of the carboxyl group. So it comes away with an extra electron and therefore as a hydroxyl ion, OH minus. Over at the other side, the H comes off the hydroxyl group, but it leaves its electron behind and comes off therefore as a hydrogen ion. And the hydrogen ion and hydroxyl ion, you can see, form water. So at the top left there, I've brought in a dicarboxylic acid monomer unit. I've removed the OH from both carboxyl groups. And I'll bring that down now and begin to grow a polyester molecule. The top right, I need the other monomer unit, the diol. And again, you see that I've removed already the H's from both ends. And in goes the diol, bonding via its oxygen to the C double bond O of the dicarboxylic acid. And we keep alternating the molecules. So note that it is both ends of both molecules that interact. In both cases, we're forming an ester linkage with the elimination of a water molecule. So it's known as condensation polymerization. In goes another diol, and then we bring in another dicarboxylic acid. So simply alternating the monomer units. We can show this in an abbreviated form as follows. What we do is to take n of the dicarboxylic acid molecules, where n is a large integer, such as 2000, and we react those with the same number of diol molecules. So again, n represents this large integer. And let's see then how we represent the polymer itself. We just show two of these joined up to form a pair, because this is the alternating unit within the polymer chain. And we show that within brackets. Notice those bonds extend on both sides from inside to outside the brackets. And the N goes in as a subscript, because we'll end up with N of those from N of each of the two monomers. Next, let's consider how many water molecules are produced here. And the answer is 2N water molecules. If you have 8 fence posts, you'll have 7 gaps in between the 8 posts. So if you take 2N of these molecules, you'll end up with 2N minus 1 water molecules. But notice that I've taken effectively another water molecule away, because I've removed the OH from the extreme left-hand side and the H from the extreme right-hand side. So this does balance. That's it. Terylene. Thanks for listening.